There'll be some important decisions made tonight before this sellout crowd of 15,000. Some gambles made by both coaches. He's been aching for it.
Hey, Dick, he's been wanting to sing this song all year long. Let him get his start.
The gambler, huh? The coaches.
Excuse me, Kenny Rogers. You got to know when to hold. You got to know when to fold. You got to know when to walk away. And you got to know when to run.
And that's the title, The Gambler, The Coaches, the marvelous men who guide these athletes during the course of a collegiate season. A musical reflection on their role on this important night.
You got to know when to hold up, know when to fold up, know when to walk away, and know when to run. You never count your money when you're sitting at the table. Time enough for counting when the dealing's done. Every gambler knows that the secret to surviving is knowing what to throw away, knowing what to keep, 'cause every hand's a winner and every hand's a loser. And the best that you can hope for is to die in your sleep. You got to know when to hold up, know when to fold up, know when to walk away, know when to run. You never count your money when you're sitting at the table. There'll be time enough to count when the deal is done.
We are getting set here for what promises to be one tremendous championship game for the National Intercollegiate Basketball title. I don't know what more you could ask. You know, we started this season, what, 6 months ago? If you'd have tabbed it right then on two of the storybook stories that could have come out of this season, one would have had to be Larry Bird. Here was a guy who could have passed up this season of college basketball and moved on to the pros. But instead, he stuck around for an ideal. An ideal that belonged to Terre Haute, Indiana, belonged to Indiana State. And now, after 33 games, he has, as unlikely as it seems, taken that team to within one game of the championship. Conversely, look at it this way. There is Irvin Johnson, a young man who many say this will be his last college game, that he will not be able to resist the lure of the pros, and that Irvin Johnson will indeed move on to pro basketball. That still remains to be seen. But you've got to wonder, we are tonight looking at perhaps the two best passing big men in the entire history of college basketball. And for both of them, right here on this floor, this could be their final ball game. The fans are getting jacked up because they're about to go off the floor. And we are nearing it. Michigan State against Indiana State. Very quickly, let's just run down how they got here. Indiana State, a winner over Virginia Tech and Oklahoma, and then by the skin of their teeth against Arkansas. End of ball. Michigan State, a winner over Lamar, a winner over powerful LSU. And then they beat a very powerful Notre Dame club. And then finally, last Saturday, came on to beat Pennsylvania. For the opening lineups, let's go to Dan Roberts.
For Michigan State University, wearing number 32 at forward, 6 feet, 7 inches tall, senior from Detroit, Michigan, Gregory Kelser. For Indiana State, wearing number 42 at forward, 6 foot, 7 inches tall, junior from East St. Louis, Illinois, Alex Gilbert. For Michigan State, wearing number 12 at forward, 6 foot, 4 inch sophomore from Windsor, Ontario, Michael Berkovich. For Indiana State, wearing number 33 at center, 6 foot, 9 inch senior from French Lick, Indiana, Larry Bird. For Michigan State, wearing number 15 at center, 6 foot, 7 inch junior from St. Croix, Virgin Islands, Ron Charles. For Indiana State, wearing number 23 at guard, 6 foot, 2 inch sophomore from Warsaw, Indiana, Steve Reed. For Michigan State, wearing number 11 at guard, 6 foot, 2 inch junior from St. Louis, Missouri, Terry Donnelly. For Indiana State, wearing number 22 at guard, 6 foot, 2 inch junior from Chicago, Illinois, Carl Nick. And from Michigan State, wearing number 33 at guard, 6 foot, 8 inch sophomore from Lansing, Michigan, Urban Magic Johnson. Welcome, please, the head coach of the Sycamores, Bill Hodges. And a welcome, please, for the head coach of the Spartans, Judd Heathcote.
G.
Judd Heathcote, 51 years of age. Indiana State's counterpart, young Bill Hodges at 36. A chance to be a national champion. And one man knows that feeling so well, and you worked a long time, Al, to get there.
Well, if Hodges becomes it, he'll be the first rookie coach in 41 years to become the national champ.
Set the scene again. Indiana State, only the 10th team in history to enter the Final Four unbeaten. Michigan State, as the Spartans break their huddle, they've started slowly. Were 5-4 after their first 9 games, then won 20 of their last 22. And they have two legitimate great players in Johnson and Kelcher, the all-time leading Michigan State scorer.
Kelcher is the third man in the ring, and that might be the difference in this game.
I think the real key for the fans early is to watch how Bill Hodges decides to match up.
Gilbert, 42. Kelcher of Michigan State, 32. They're both 6'7". Michigan State controls. Donnelly in the backcourt. The key, many feel, to beating Michigan State is to take the early lead. When the Spartans get in front in a hurry, they're really tough. Johnson traveling. Johnson tripped over a foot, and it belongs to Indiana State.
It was Brad Miley, a very good defensive basketball player, and he's the guy going to have that responsibility. 6'8", so there won't be any posting up, Al.
23, Steve Reed, unheralded, but an excellent shooter, a sophomore. And here's the great player, Bird. Reed open. Indiana State takes the early lead.
Very interesting that Larry Bird is going ahead and playing the same kind of offense that they would against the man-to-man.
I don't think Indiana State's going to be able to stay man-to-man. Michigan State will force him into his zone.
Ron Charles on a feed from Kelcher ties it up.
Now watch this double stack down here for Larry Bird to try to get open early.
Carl Nix. Rebound Johnson. Magic Johnson with the ball.
One of the great things that Irvin Johnson can do is out of the zone matchup defense. He's a great rebounder and never has to make an outlet pass because he is the outlet pass himself. Nix cuts him out from underneath, but he made the shot anyway. Look at him.
Just a sophomore. Many hope he'll stay around to compete on the collegiate level again next year.
And also in the Olympics in Russia.
5-2, Michigan State on the three-point play by All-American Irvin Johnson. Bird, first basket will make him number 5 all time. Kelcher rebounds. Johnson with a magic out there. Bird rebounds. Goes from one great player to another, and Kelcher knocks it out of bounds for Michigan State.
Larry Bird also is a guy that can grab it off the boards and take it up court, not as flamboyantly as Johnson does, but he knows what he's doing when he has that ball.
Larry Bird's trying to get in the middle of the zone and manhandle Charles in there.
Turned over, 2-on-2, Berkovich. And Donnelly will slow it up. Kelcher over the top to Indiana State.
And you notice who's matched up with Kelcher. Larry Bird really taking on a big assignment, both ends of the floor.
I thought they put Bird on Charles because he's not expendable. But Bill Hodges is coming right at them. He's playing his game.
Bird dumps it off to Gilbert.
Bird's going to try to move through the matchup zone, taking men with him. It's awful difficult not to follow him through because when he gets it, he can make the play.
Johnson to Kelcher. The academic All-American can't hit it. Rebound, Bird. Indiana State has its first opportunity. Well, after the opening bucket to take and regain the lead. Bird, 20-footer. And a foul on Donnelly. action in.
Judd Heathcote a little upset with it, but Larry Bird right away, here comes a timeout coming up, has decided to go over on the other side of that zone. Here comes the play. Turnaround jump shot, not there. Dishes off inside. Gilbert goes up. He's a great leaper from inside.
An interesting early timeout called by Michigan State's Judd Heathcote. We've played less than 3 minutes in Salt Lake City. Michigan State leads by one. Michigan State's Judd Heathcote called that time, and he's agonizing already.
He made a terrific move as a coach. Only 2 minutes and 45 seconds have been used up in the game. There's something wrong inside their zone with Larry Bird cutting across, and he adjusted it.
If Larry Bird makes this free throw, he becomes the number five scorer in college history. He now joins a select group, Pete Maravich, Freeman Williams, Oscar Robertson, Elvin Hayes, and Larry Bird, number five.
Al, I think they're going to bring Magic more outside because Miley handles him down there when he posts up. He might be better off playing a guard position.
Good defense by Indiana State. Bird is on Kelser, knocks it away. Nicks against Conley, and he's going to slow it down.
Oh,
what a pass by Bird, but it handcuffed Gilbert.
Gilbert didn't come to meet the pass that time. It was there.
Watch on the weak side to helping out inside on the bucket. If Johnson posts up, Bird will help out. If Kelser posts up, Miley will help out.
Kelser handing off another easy two to Charles. They're overplaying Kelser, and he's fed two easy layups to Ron Charles.
Well, Alex Gilbert tried to help out that time. When he helped out, no guard pulled back in.
Gilbert, baseline. Urban Johnson brings it down court for Michigan State. Oh, deflected out of bounds. No, last touch by Charles. It goes to Indiana State.
Here we see the play inside. Kelser makes his move. Now coming over to try to help out. What happened? Miley never shifted over. Ron Charles wide open.
Indiana State with the ball, trailing by one. 4 minutes gone. Bird.
Oh,
what a shooter.
They're having a problem trying to adjust the Bird going across the baseline of the zone and trying to nest in the middle here, which I said at the top of the show.
Bird with 4 points. Indiana State leads by one. Kelser. Conley shoots rarely. Right down the bottom of the well. And Michigan State leads 9-8 with 4.5 minutes gone.
Greg Kelser has a great first step, and what he's doing is giving Larry Bird a lot, and they're trying to help Bird out a little bit. Therefore, other people are open away from the ball.
Carl Nix, 20-footer, way short. Donnelly gets the long carom. Remember, the most valuable player in this game, Gillette Razor Company, will send a $5,000 check in his honor to that institution. Greg Kelser shooting for 2,000 points in his career, more than any Spartan ever, has given Michigan State its biggest lead.
That was the best offensive play of the game so far.
Has it stolen away. Three on one. Berkovich scores. Basket good. Foul is on Reed of Indiana State.
Great outlet pass by Magic Johnson. We talk again about his ability. Now here we have the play right before. Kelser beat Bird on the baseline. Gilbert didn't slide over to protect. Here we have Magic Johnson throwing the ball out. Three on one, as you said, Dick. Berkovich takes it right to the hole. Reed not in position to stop him. Coming on down, they call a foul on Reed.
When Reed moved his arm, that's a foul. If you get position, you must hold and not move any part of your body. Otherwise, it's a blocking foul.
Bill Hodges trying to get an advantage over there. Telling his assistants, just relax and sit down. There was a blocking call.
Is he calling that a two-shot foul?
I can't believe he did, because he certainly didn't cut his legs out. He was standing there to draw the charge.
Called it a flagrant foul.
I can't buy that one at all.
Berkovich, the best free throw shooter for the Spartans, misses the front end. He's 84.7% on the year. This only 9 of 59.
That flagrant foul, Al, a man's got to deliberately try to cut your legs out from underneath you, and he was just standing there waiting.
Michigan State, and this is what they've done throughout the tournament, take the early lead, and they have steamrollered a couple of clubs. Closest anyone has come to Michigan State, Notre Dame, and they lost by 12.
Ron Charles picking up Bird, coming across the lane, and then as soon as he goes past the lane, he's picked up by Kelsey. Watch him coming across.
Larry Bird took a shot, little short jumper, and he didn't have any place to go with it.
He got hung in the air. He wanted to give it to Alex, but couldn't get it in.
Johnson to Kelsey, and a foul on Gilbert, Indiana State. His first.
Billy, I think Kelsey cleared out that time before he put the shot up with his inside arm.
Well, he might have, but the thing that's so amazing about Magic Johnson is the pressure he puts on the defense, bringing that ball down the court.
We return to our studios for this message with a score 14-8, Michigan State, and 14 minutes to play. As it was against Pennsylvania on Saturday, the Spartans from the Big Ten, the hot early shooting hand, the other team a bit cold.
Well, Indiana State is shooting from the perimeter, much more difficult shots. But Michigan State is shooting from tight into the basket.
You know, Dick, there's so much adrenaline flowing, but when you play against Michigan State early, you've got to be patient to look for some openings. You're not going to be able to get that shot up right away against the matchup zone they play.
Greg Kelsey looking for his fourth point. And Michigan State now has doubled the score, 16-8. We're playing less than 6 minutes. And this, Alex, where you say the zone gets tougher.
Yes.
They start backing that zone up, making it tougher and tougher to get it inside. Oh, he double dribbled
it. Got away with it. Bird dumps it off, and he was fouled by Donnelly.
Maybe the officials are a little psyched up, too. Carl Nix dribbled the ball twice.
Larry made a little mistake then. When he felt the hand on him, he should have put the ball at the basket. It would have been an automatic two-shot foul instead of just a one-shot foul and taking the ball out the side.
Ron Charles almost playing Bird man-to-man when he's in any area in the middle of that matchup zone.
We're about to see our first substitute. Bob Heaton is checking in at the scores table. He's been their dramatic star, winning four games at the buzzer this year.
He's a good outside shooter. Indiana State gets stronger as they move in their subs. Their sixth and seventh man are equal or better than their fourth and fifth man.
Here comes Bob Heaton. He's from a small Indiana town, 150 population, Corey, Indiana. And good shooter.
Dick, now they have an unusual defensive matchup, though, because they have three guards in the game, which is, we're going to have to see which one of those three guards is going to take Magic Johnson, for the simple reason that Miley would have to go back inside.
Bob Heaton is not a guard. He can play guard or play forward.
Bird inside. This is beautiful. College basketball's player of the year, Larry Bird, has 6 points.
Looks like Heaton's going to take the center position defensively. It's Charles.
Kelsey, 20-footer. Rebound, Miley. And here comes Indiana State. The Sycamores trail by six. 13 minutes left, first half.
Carl Nix got to start perking.
I'm sure Judge Heathcote likes where he is, but if he puts a big man in the game right now, he'd sure have domination on the board.
Heaton misses, Kelsey rebounds, and here's Magic Johnson for the ball.
They don't give Magic Johnson a ball until he gets into the offensive end of the court.
Johnson runs, oh. Kelsey scores.
Got a break.
Kelsey is bleeding from the nose or mouth. He apparently was struck in getting that last rebound. Carl Nix can't hit. Charles takes it away from his own teammate, and they call traveling.
What's happening right now? Bill Hodges is a very small team in the game, and you really have domination on the inside. You got Charles, a great leaper, in the middle. Kelsey, of course, a great leaper, and Magic Johnson all across the front line can get up there. Indiana State a little bit outmanned.
18-10, Michigan State. Look at the jam up around Byrne when he goes inside. Steve Reed can't hit. Heat rebound, foul on Magic Johnson. He knew it.
Yep, it was a good call.
Right, came right across the lane.
It's interesting, gentlemen, that if
Indiana State wins, the Hoosier State will have two champions. The Hoosiers have already won the NIT. If Indiana State wins, if Michigan State wins, then the Big Ten Conference will throw out its chest because they will have had the NIT and NCAA champs.
Hoosier hysteria.
Boy, they really are boxing in Larry Bird right now. He's got two men on him. They're going over to his side completely with the defense.
Bird and Johnson in the back of that zone defense. Magic against Bird.
See, the two front men, Donnelly and Berkovich, they play the foul line extended. They take the foul line all the way to the side of the court. Here's the foul.
Bird tips it in. Larry Bird using that left hand. Remember, he has a broken left thumb on that left hand.
Well, all he has to do with that, they're not allowed anything but a foam sponge and tape around it. That's an NCAA rule.
18-12, Michigan State with the ball and the lead. Magic Johnson from 15, and he loves to hit that backboard.
Certainly can't hit the outside shot, can he?
7 for Johnson and 8 for Bird so far.
He's proven in this tournament particularly that he has nice range of a 15-foot, 18-foot shot to hit the ball. Good patience by Indiana State. They're not just firing it up on the outside. They're looking to get the ball in.
There's Nix inside. And the basket is allowed. A foul against Michigan State.
Here's Larry Bird constantly in motion, trying to get position. You see Magic Johnson shielding one way. Here comes Charles over. Double teamed. He goes underneath the two. Puts it up left hand. Now watch him bounce for the offensive rebound. He is a tough player and a constant movement.
He has complete control of his body.
Foul was on Greg Kelser, Michigan State, his second. And Carl Nix looking for the three-point play. He's just made his first points of the night. 20-15, the Spartans lead cut to 5 as we approach the halfway mark of this first 20-minute period.
They're setting up a trap right now.
Jay Vincent in the game. Now you really have the power, team. Kelser sat down.
There's Vincent. He can't connect, but Charles rips it home. Bobo Charles has 6.
He got inside Leroy Staley that time. An easy tap, and he's very quick off his feet.
Well, Bill Hodges realizes he's awful small across the front line right now. He's
got that zone, Cal. Check that zone from this long angle. You see how those white shirts really do jam inside. Heaton was fouled.
One of the reasons there is Vincent can't react that fast. He's only about 80% recovered from the foot injury.
And here you have the bigger lineup coming back. I tell you, Bill Hodges and Judd Heathcote, two guys really staying with this ball game.
Ron Charles has his first foul. Bob Heaton at the line.
The matchups are so important physically in there. And now he has Staley and he has Gilbert and he has Bird in the front line, and they can go up on the ball.
22-16, Heaton has his first point.
Bob Heaton got his arm caught in a corn picking machine when he was 11 years of age. He got 60 stitches in his left arm.
22-17, Michigan State by 5. The winner replaces the University of Kentucky as basketball champions. Away from the ball, foul is on Leroy Staley, 44, just into the game for Indiana State. He's from Tampa, Florida, went to Jefferson High School there.
He's just trying to make sure that Magic Johnson doesn't get the ball down low. He's trying to fight him off defensively before he ever handles it. You see it right here. Now watch him. He doesn't want Magic to get that ball. Using his hands, trying to gain advantage, and there was the foul.
Inside to Johnson, over Staley. Not there. Rebound Bird and a foul on Vincent of Michigan State over the top.
That's a close call underneath there, Billy.
Well, excellent position again by Larry Bird. Boy, he has his feet moving all the time. Gets in position both to score and to rebound. Greg Kelser sitting down over there, Dick. You have him down for 2 fouls or what?
Pardon me, Billy.
Kelser down for 2 fouls. That's probably why he said.
I believe in the first half you save a man at the 2 fouls. The second half you save him after 3. When he gets 4 fouls, let him go. He's no good to you.
He's coming back in.
The Sycamores trying to cut into that 5-point lead. 9 minutes, 40 seconds left, first half. Great halftime picture. Magic Johnson, Larry Bird to music in slow motion. Don't go away at halftime. is Larry Bird's mother from Southern Indiana cheering her now famous son.
She was funny the other night after the game. She said, too many turnovers.
34 points, but she was looking at that turnover list. Her son committed 11 mistakes. Bob Heaton. Rebound Donnelly.
The secondary players are not hitting that perimeter shot.
Oh, Bird! Great play by Bird.
And he saves it.
That was an alley-oop pass almost, trying to get it into Kelson.
Standing ovation from some of the fans, and they're not in the Indiana State section. Bird hanging, can't score. Johnson to Berkovich. 3-on-2. Vincent fouled by Heaton, number 30. Bob Heaton gets the foul. He stopped the easy layup.
Larry Bird a little upset with himself missing that shot. Here you go, Magic Johnson throwing it up, and look at Bird hustling down the floor. Now, he was under the basket when that play started to develop, went the full 90 feet for the interception.
The bird that flies the highest sees the forest.
Al McGuire, Marks, 1979.
Is that farthest or forest?
Forest.
I still don't know.
Jay Benson, he's from Lansing, Michigan. Same class as Irvin Johnson. They were high school competitors near the Michigan State campus. That's Benson's first point. He's playing on a very sore right foot. 9 minutes left in the first half.
They need this basket right here.
Larry Bird's getting buried in that zone a little bit.
Oh, Nix hammers in a two-pointer, 23-19.
That's very important. Carl Nix got to start penetrating into the zone to either kick off or shoot the ball.
Larry Bird with the arm, says the official, as Kelser left him in his tracks. Kelser is lightning quick with that first step.
Larry Bird trying to figure him out a little bit defensively. He's going to back off him now because he's beaten him with a first set.
He can't play a man-to-man out on the side when they isolate him. He pushed with his left arm inside that time.
And what's asking him, you know, physically to go and play Kelser and one into the floor and then be constantly moving in the offensive end is tough.
Team fouls. Both have six. Johnson can't connect. Gets his own rebound and can't score. Foul underneath. Apparently on Gilbert, and now, although this is a shooting foul, both teams from now on will go to the 1-1. Gilbert, a great leaper, junior college. He high jumps 7 feet. He hopes after basketball or with basketball, he might make it to Moscow as a high jumper.
He has a 40-inch vertical jump.
Magic Johnson, incredibly fine free throw shooter, and there's a member of the Johnson family. I believe that's his grandfather, Jesse Johnson. A miss, and out of bounds to Michigan State. Larry Bird can't believe he was not fouled.
He looked like he broke his wing that time when he's laying on the floor.
Here we see it right here. He's going up. A lot of bodies battling. No question about the foul. He got knocked to the floor.
Here it is again, a Bird and a foul.
Definitely got fouled right here. Watch him get knocked to the floor, and they say it's Michigan State out of bounds. Tough call for Indiana State.
There he goes. He let his head go back at the end in frustration.
He caught a pretty good elbow in the back of the head.
Oh, he's a tough kid.
There's that man-to-man out of bounds again, Al.
Bird with a block. Heaton can't save it. What a hustle effort by Heaton. He was out of bounds anyway. But Bird showing defensively his great timing as well.
It's a real competitor as all the great players of all-time in college basketball are. Beautiful block.
Inside Vincent. Goaltending, and it would not have gone in. That's goaltending, but a mistake made by Staley. The ball was not online.
Here comes Miley in the ball game to take him on out of there. Staley at times coming in off the bench. We'll see it here, and you were right, Dick. It never would have gone into the basket. But I think what Bill Hodges does well in his substitutions, he gives a try, Al. As you pointed out, his sixth and seventh men may be better than his fourth and fifth, but he gives them a try, gets them back in there later.
He never takes a ball player out of a game for a mistake. He takes him out for a defensive or offensive adjustment.
Larry Bird, way on the top, but Kelser can't handle the rebound. Kelser, not only the all-time great scorer in Michigan State history, but their top rebounder again this year.
Bird hasn't yet found out where he really wants to get the ball against this matchup zone.
Michigan State, 26 in Indiana State, 19, 8 minutes left, first half.
And your space eaters in the middle, Al.
Jay Vincent, number 31, takes up a lot of room inside that zone.
That's a tough matchup.
Kelser very nearly stole it, and he did deflect it off the hands of Larry Bird.
Notice they don't get the ball to Magic Johnson until they get into the offensive zone.
Kelser, 18-footer, not there. Rebound Gilbert, and a foul on Johnson, his second. Magic Johnson, the agony of the whistle.
Yeah, it's hard to believe there. That was a little touch foul on Magic, and before we had a guy blasted to the floor.
Bill Hodges, young Indiana State coach. Some of you watching Indiana State, Michigan State for the first time. Bill Hodges took over as head coach this year when Bob King, a veteran coach at Indiana State, suffered a heart attack and then surgery for brain aneurysm. Bob King is here recuperating. He's still the athletic director and cheering young Bill Hodges, first year head coach, perfect 33-0. Way off the line, Gilbert, notoriously bad free throw shooter, but Bird gets it. Can't score. Out of bounds. Well, I believe Indiana State got a break on that one. It appeared to touch Gilbert last.
Alex Gilbert shoots 27% from the foul line. When he makes one down in Terre Haute, the whole student body stands up and applauds him.
You were trying to challenge him to a little one-on-one yesterday.
He almost breaks the glass when he shoots a foul shot.
26-19.
Boy, that defense clogs things up so beautifully.
Bird, way short. That was partially blocked by Berkovich. Nix, beautiful pass to Gilbert and a foul on Berkovich. You saw Johnson leap in the air. Magic thought they were going to call it on him.
Nix is starting to create problems inside the zone now. They have to have this. Nix got to have a good game to neutralize the zone inside. He has to penetrate.
That's a pretty good block coming over the top by Berkovich. Had his hand right on the ball.
Gilbert again, 27% free throw shooter. Incredible. He is now this year 20 out of 77.
You know what's amazing about him, too, is the fact that he has decent form. It's got to be concentration on his part.
Well, 0 for 3.
Luke Chamberlain had the same problem. I believe he should play the shot off the backboard, and if it misses, at least the rebound would go further out into the area where you have your own men.
Inside is Vincent to score, and Michigan State now has jumped into a 9-point lead. 7 minutes left, first half. Sycamores really need a bucket this trip down court. Bird with a good save. What hands.
Wow.
The basket is not allowed. They're calling the foul on Larry Bird.
He pushed in. Larry Bird's getting a little frustrated now because he can't find an opening in which he can get his offensive move started.
You watch, he drops his shoulder in a moment. Gets the ball over here. Gives a head fake. Watch this. He gives a head fake. Now he drops his shoulder in.
There's Bird hit him.
And he didn't barely touch Kelser. Pretty good acting job by Kelser. He fell at the right time.
State scores here. Indiana has to call a timeout.
And Magic Johnson hanging and hitting a 12-footer. 30-19, the Spartans lead. 6:28 remaining in the first half. No timeout called by the Sycamores.
Anytime Larry Bird touches it, there are about three people in his area.
Bird left alone. He's automatic.
Doesn't tighten up. Puts his shot up the same way every time. He missed about four shots in a row. The fifth one, exactly the same form.
10 points for Magic Johnson. 10 points for Larry Bird.
Vincent's doing a good job out there.
Well, Judd Heathcote said he'll play as long as hard as he has to.
Johnson inside, follows his own shot, and Bird saves it. 30-21, Michigan State. 5.5 minutes remaining. First half.
Steve Reed has to start shooting from the top of that key.
Nix will fire and hit. Carl Nix has hit two in a row, has 7 points.
Now Magic Johnson's moving to the backcourt. Going to start his own offense.
Wiley on it. Here's a forward. playing against the guard because Johnson at 6'8 creates unusual problems defensively. Out of bounds to Michigan State.
When Magic Johnson brings the ball up, he's going to pass off to one of the guards, then post up.
Timeout. 5 minutes, 14 seconds left in the first half. The Spartans lead the Sycamores by 7. Well, this game tonight will conclude our exciting year of college basketball. It's the Golden Gloves Association of American Tournament of Champions from Indianapolis. We'll be pleased to be chatting about the top amateur boxers in the nation with you on Sports World. That's Sunday at 4 o'clock Eastern Time. Let's check statistically on the Johnson-Bird matchup. Each with 10 points. Each with one assist, and Bird has two more rebounds.
Little over 5 minutes left to go for the half.
Kelser off to Johnson, wide open. Kelser has become the assist man in this first half.
We really have four front court men in the game right now for Michigan State, and Berkovich is a good leaper at about 6'4". They've changed their zone defense completely.
Knicks way off the mark. Rebound Charles. Johnson, 3-on-1.
Here it comes.
The alley-oop to Greg Kelser.
Nick, this is going to be a very critical time for Indiana State because this is a massive lineup that Michigan State has in the game right now. All the big people
in that zone. Somebody has to be open when they collapse a zone. 2 men on a wing. Bird deep in the corner. Push off. Irvin Johnson pushing for Michigan State. And Magic Johnson has his third foul.
Here we're going to see the play. Of course, Kelsey's already moved, getting himself in position. Look at the timing here between those two great individuals.
Magic Johnson this year. I don't believe he's fouled out. Maybe once.
No, 5 times he's fouled out, I remember. During the year.
They don't have that on their statistical sheet. But 3 fouls to sit down the Magic man has to hurt Michigan State. If nothing else, just emotionally, he gives that team such a spirit.
Well, the thing I think it really hurts is I believe Judd Heathcote really loved the team he had on the floor at this given time with his 4 big men in the game. The zone was really going to be tough to get anything inside on.
Miley has not scored in the game. Kelsey rebounds. Michigan State with an 11-point lead. That's the largest of the game.
Foul shooting is hurting Indiana State. That was the front of a 1-1 that time.
Inside to Kelser. A little short. Keaton gets the rebound on a tip out.
Need a basket bed.
I'm surprised Larry Bird's finding himself over in Kelser's side all the time. Kelsey's such a great leaper over there. Of course, Charles is too, so it's out of the frying pan into the fire no matter where you go, I guess.
Charles has taken that backline spot that Irvin Johnson usually works.
See, Jay Vincent being able to play really helps Michigan State.
Nice play by Charles. Intercepts the pass intended for Bird.
Indiana State stays in a hard man-to-man. Oh, they open up. Kelsey will go around them.
Oh, good help by Carl Nix. Real good help.
Yeah, Miley fell down, and Nix came in to pick up Kelsey, who had design on driving. Less than 3 minutes left in the first half. Berkovich on the live, traveling. 1979 NCAA Basketball Championship Program is a Momento you'll treasure. Exclusive information on the Final Four, tournament records, plus plenty of photos, features, much more contained in this collector's issue. Send a check or money order for $4 to NCAA Program, Box 1979, Lexington, Kentucky, 40594. Preceding message was furnished by the NCAA.
Al, nobody's tried to screen any of those front guys. They've got to get some guard play out here, taking some shots at the perimeter. There's one.
Keaton can't hit. Rebound to Vincent. You saw that zone again, collapsing in.
Yeah, they're losing their poise a little bit, Indiana State.
Oh, you knew it was coming.
Oh, he missed it. But there was a foul on Gilbert. of Indiana State. Kelser going for the ram, and he hit the iron.
Watch how high they get up. Excuse me, Billy. Go ahead.
You knew it was coming. Brad Miley had been kind of lulled to sleep a little bit by Kelser. There he goes up. Two great leapers going against each other.
Oh, that's unbelievable, the height that Gilbert gets up.
Pause briefly for station identification. This is the NBC Television Network.
You got two shots, man.
Dick Enberg with Al McGuire and Billy Packer, Salt Lake City, the final game of this 1979 season. Michigan State, after Indiana State scored the first goal of the game, has taken command and now leads by 11 points, although their star Magic Johnson is on the bench with three fouls. Now Staley returns for Indiana State as Gilbert with three takes a rest. Kelser looking for his seventh point. Biggest lead for Michigan State, 35-23. And now Johnson, the cheerleader.
Special K is a great ball player.
Bob Heaton, he hits a clutch goal. It's 35-25, four for Heaton.
That's what it'll take to open some things up for Burns. Perimeter shots by the guards.
Nicks a near interception. Indiana State has been in more close games, at least of late. They've won two games in this tournament by 2 points, their last two against Arkansas and DePaul. Michigan State has had a relatively easy time. Some thought if it was a close game, it would be to the advantage of Indiana State.
I believe that because Indiana State has been through it. Michigan State hasn't. They've been blowing teams out. And the tendency is to tighten up in a close game.
Berkovich had an easy 15-footer and overpass. Indiana State gets a break.
Bird on top of his game again defensively.
Give it to Heaton in the corner. He's free. Give it to him. There he is. Shoot it up.
Two for two for Bob Heaton. How do you know those things?
That's what I got paid for 19 years of coaching. It's automatic.
A minute and a half left in this first 20 minutes. Michigan State by eight. Heaton has 6 points.
Going to be Gonzalez coming in the game to play that back line. Good patience by Kelser. He doesn't try to force the shot.
Both outstanding coaches.
Minute and eight. Looks like they're trying to set up a while.
Yeah, big difference whether it's a 10-point or a 6-point halftime differential.
Yeah, when you go in with double digits down, psychologically it affects you. Michigan State, if they can do it, I don't think they can hold it for 54 seconds.
Caught in the cookie jar, 44, Staley. It's his second foul.
Staley's the only married fella on Indiana State. Wife's name is Crystal.
Magic Johnson on the sidelines, doing a little coaching. Mike Berkovich trying to help him. Never seen a man more involved once he takes the court, whether he's playing, watching. He does everything but sell programs.
And here's a guy that does that. Kelser is truly an All-American basketball player.
And an academic All-American, a B student in criminal justice on the Michigan State campus. He now has 9 points, and Michigan State back on top by 10.
There's Coach Wooden. He coached at Indiana State for 2 years before he went on to UCLA.
That's right, in the late 40s. Heaton can't hit. Bird saves it. Open is next. Oh, and a play by Greg Kelser. He took it right out of his hands.
Special K.
That was an incredible play.
Down to the final seconds of this first half. A 10-point lead. There goes Kelser. Lost the ball to Bird. And a foul on Kelser.
That's a smart play by Larry Bird. That's his third.
Boy, this is a dangerous call there because it's the third foul on Greg Kelser.
Well, that doesn't make it dangerous, Al. That makes it the third.
Well, but I'm saying they could have had him out of the game or they could have pulled up and played for one shot.
Well, Larry Bird did a smart thing. Here's Nick's getting knocked out of bounds a little bit. But watch a great catch by Kelser. Comes down and rips it on off of there. And here we'll see the play. He was going to try to behind the back this to Vincent. Lost the handle. Bird touched it a little bit. Picks it up. Now Bird, being smart, realizes Kelser's coming. Just goes underneath him and lets him draw the foul.
Well, that's really a thin call, isn't it?
Well, a man knocks him down. I think
he was falling.
Call.
I mean, again, it points out the acting. You have to be
a dramatist in order to play this game anymore.
Beautiful, Dick, beautiful. Carl Nix got hit on the other end of the court a moment before.
You like the falling
down? I don't know how to say dramatist, but I think that's what you're trying to say, Professor.
37-28, final second. Jay Vincent, and Charles has it knocked away to Indiana State at the buzzer, the end of the first half. 20 minutes to go. At the intermission, the score. Michigan State, 37, Indiana State, 28, and neither Bill Hodges of Indiana State nor Judd Heathcote of the Spartans very happy about the men in the black and white shirts. A great halftime show coming up. Stay with us. Michigan State outscoring, outshooting from the floor and the free throw line, leading by 9 points as we open the second half. Same five players will start for each club. That means that Irvin Johnson, Greg Kelser with three fouls, and Alex Gilbert of Indiana State also playing with three. Kelser, Gilbert, jump it off.
They're both going to go upstairs on this.
Kelser got it in the first half. Gilbert got it in that half, but it went back to Johnson. We introduce the players for you. Donley and Berkovich in the backcourt presently with Charles Johnson posting up and Kelser for Michigan State. Nix and Reed, the guards for Indiana State. Bird, Wiley, Gilbert, the front line. Kelser, Kay hits it, danced it home.
Boy, he felt the defensive pressure coming from the weak side that time and pulled up for the jumper.
Michigan State's biggest lead was 12 points in the first half. Indiana State led last at 8-7 early in the game.
Steve Reed got a shoot. Put it up.
Wide open. Can't hit it. Rebound Charles. Magic Johnson.
Now they're just ignoring Reed and, of course, Miley in the particular, any kind of offensive structure they have, and that's hurting them.
Terry Donnelly, that's how the game began, with a little left-hander hitting a jumper from the side. He has 4 points, one early in the game, one early in this half.
We can watch him coming down. All the pressure is completely on Larry Bird right now. Look at the pressure around him. Two, three, net.
And he's short. The second half does not start well for the Sycamores.
Johnson going outside, directing that offense. He's switching with Donley a little bit.
Almost turned it over. Back door to Charles. And he is fouled. Gilbert has his fourth.
That's one of the problems in playing man-to-man, overplaying. You're vulnerable to the backdoor pass. If you notice in this, he goes high, then goes backdoor on Gilbert, and obviously it should have been a simple dunk. He caught him for his fourth foul. It'll be two shots in the line.
No move by Bill Hodges to replace Gilbert.
Well, he's down now. He's going to have to play for all the marbles.
Ron Charles from the Virgin Islands. Was a member of the Virgin Island Pan American team at the age of 16.
One shot, man. Calm game.
He started the first 19 games this year. Berkovich knocked him out of the starting spot.
Charles has his 7th point, and Michigan State enjoys its widest margin of this game, 14 points.
Charles, everybody foul Larry Bird wherever he goes. They just won't let him touch that ball. Which means Reed's got to be open.
Bird, short again.
The tough
Miley
shot.
Rebounds. Bird, and they're right at the basket.
Bill Hodges going for a timeout. The game getting away from his team.
Michigan State has the ball, has a 14-point lead, and the green and white clad fans from East Lansing, Michigan smell a championship. They've come from everywhere, Hawaii, Alaska, the entire 50 states, 15,410 to see the 1979 national championship game, and Larry Bird has had a cold shooting night, but obviously a great defense from the Spartan, hawking him throughout.
Plenty of time left. There's over 17 minutes left.
Johnson pass deflected out to Berkovich.
Both teams are playing good defense. Nobody getting anything easy out here.
Indiana's trying to travel.
Kelser and Bird are matched up on the Indiana State defense. There they are. And Kelser from behind the backboard nails one.
That was a great shot. Fading away, spinning the opposite direction.
16-point lead, 17-15 left. Kelser has 13 to lead all scores.
See Magic Johnson and Ron Charles have it sandwiched in.
Basket is good. The foul is on Terry Donnelly. Donnelly of Michigan State, his second foul.
Here he is, Dick. Look at, they have him sandwiched in completely. You just can't get him the ball. When he gets it, he's trying to force a little bit.
I think he should stay underneath like that, look for inside position, let the other fellow shoot, because every time he gets a rebound, it'd be 2 points or possibly a three-point play.
Nix unable to get the three-point play, but Heaton looking for a four-pointer. No foul. Indiana State fans unhappy. They wanted a whistle. Magic double team.
There's the trap you were talking about, Al, but men are going to be open like Terry Donnelly.
Here's the little guard, rarely shoots, averages 5-6 points a game, but when he's open, he's deadly.
He's the quarterback. He's steady. He does his job. Anything to win the game.
That zone is backed in inside the foul line area now, so Bird's really going to have problems.
Steve Reed has to take some step jumpers. He has to take the shot.
Bob Heaton connects, and it's 46-32. 16 minutes left.
That's basically the same play we saw before. Man going up for the jumper. If he doesn't leave the floor, he's all right.
Donnelly's. Terry Donnelly hits again. The junior from St. Louis, Missouri, averaging 6 points a game, has eight tonight on 4 15-footers. Carl Nix, not there, rebound Berkovich. Berkovich hit in the face, but he's okay.
Berkovich a good leaper, about 6'4", so that gives them a big guard in there along with a good size.
Foul is on Kelser, number four, as Bird had position, and Kelser called for charging.
He wanted to take Larry one-on-one that time, Billy. Here it is, Billy.
Here we see it now. It's going to be a big factor right here, the foul situation.
Didn't quite see the completion of the charge, but Kelser unable to get around Bird, who was taking, here it is.
Here it is.
Here we see him trying to go. Larry Bird moves in excellent position, shoulder to shoulder, draws the charge.
So Kelser, leading the game and scoring with 13, is out with four fouls. Number 31, Jay Vincent, has replaced him for Michigan State. The Spartans out shooting the Sycamores by plenty.
I don't want to hurt the Magic fans, but I think Greg Kelser is the most important man on the spot.
Carl Nix is open and hits. He has an unorthodox shooting shot, kind of turns his wrist, but that shot's available.
You know, with a 16-point spread, I feel momentum turning now for Indiana State. Let's see what happens.
Great passing by Michigan State, and Donnelly is 4-for-4.
That's what makes the Magic so great. Instead of trying to penetrate in here when it's not available, hit the ball around to the free man.
Heaton from 18, and he connects, and suddenly the pace quickens.
They've got to pick up all over the court, put more pressure on. Gamble on the double team, there it is. Up, he went back and over. That's it.
Traveling against Berkovich, who put on the brakes but went from the front court to the back court.
Watch Judd to call a timeout. He's losing the momentum of the game.
A lot of good pressure up here. Magic Johnson throws a very tough pass for Berkovich to have to handle right there, and a good job by Larry Bird defensively.
Again, Bird, not known for his defense, makes big plays at that end, too. Bird can't can't connect, and he grimaces as that ball refused to fall for him.
That's the second time he was in good position down in low, has a man on his back. They're sliding the man to the deep corner. That leaves Bird open under there against Jay Vincent. Puts it right up, and he wanted this one.
Oh, such a soft touch, even at that. It just danced on the rim.
My ball! Stay here! Stay here!
Well, it's not the Larry Bird that has shot Indiana State through a 33-0 year.
The fouls have been hurting them, but I still feel they're on the come.
50-37. Michigan State with 14 minutes plus remaining.
This full court pressure really did a good job against Arkansas.
Berkovich is open. Rebound, Staley, 44 on the sycamore. Indiana State trying to cut into that big Michigan State advantage.
Next time down, Al, I think you can look for Judd Heathcote to try to get his team calmed down with a timeout.
I thought he would have done it the last time.
Two men on Bird, Johnson and Vincent. Knicks off to Staley. Basket is good, and the foul is on Charles. Oh, my.
Judd's going on over there.
Crazy.
Judd has to watch out for a technical foul.
Here's the dish in here. Good penetration by Knicks. Now watch it right here. Staley just bangs into him, knocks him down. The basket counts. Got to question the call.
Would you have been on your feet, Al?
I'd be on top of the bench. I lack vocabulary in those situations.
But that's part of momentum, getting the calls, and now they get a jump ball. So things are turning a bit, and as you've said, in the course of 40 minutes, everyone's going to have their turn. The momentum will flow, and now it appears to be Bill Hodges getting the breaks.
And you know, when you're 33-0, you guys are never going to quit. They've been behind before.
There's the time.
They had a call.
Judd Heathcote angry at the officials and worried now about this game with Kelser on the sidelines. We'll be back. 11-point Michigan State advantage. Indiana State trailing Michigan State by 11. 50-39, 13 minutes, 44 seconds. It has not been a good night for Bird. Well, his poorest nights of the year.
Well, it probably is, but you've got to credit Michigan State defense for that. They've forced him out of the shooting territory. He's been trying to generate offense all by himself. Therefore, he's not taking his normal shot.
The biggest problem is they're shooting 7 for 15 in the foul line, which is 43%. And a lot of those foul shots were the front end of a 1-1 in the first half.
Staley had that tip, but tipped it right into the hands of Michigan State.
You notice who's getting the ball now. Magic Johnson bringing it up to clear it out for him.
Johnson against Staley, double teamed as Knicks gamble. Look at him hustle back and get his man.
Oh, Knicks a great athlete.
He's dazzling quick.
Michigan State going to play with a little bit.
Over.
Not going for the basket.
That pass went to Judd Heathcote. He said, hey, I don't want the ball.
Greg Kelser means so much to Michigan State that it's frightening.
Kelser on the sidelines with four fouls. 13 minutes left. Bob Heath is short. And Heath gets it back. Feeds it to Bird. Bird scores!
Here comes your move.
Here comes the clock.
Michigan State definitely rattled now. And they're looking for another offensive weapon, you know what? Kelser on the bench, they don't have another score ready.
Rebound, Larry Bird. Michigan State's 16-point lead has been whittled to 9.
Magic might have got away with a charge that time. But Michigan State's a great ball club. They're rallying back, too. But I think Indiana State still has the momentum.
Three. Bird.
Oh.
Ron Charles with a foul. No basket. Bird thought he had 2 points. He was hustling down on defense.
What's really helping them right now is they're getting some penetration. Reed on the inside. We'll see the foul right here. Bird's got that position. Grabbed him by the arm. Never really did have the ball. Good call on the inside. Bird's going to the line.
Ron Charles did the holding.
It's not a shooting foul, and it'll be Indiana State playing it from the side. Out goes Saley, returning number 40, Brad Miley, the junior from Rushville, Indiana. He's their top defensive forward.
You can feel the confidence level really picking up for Indiana State, too, particularly from the outside. Reed and Heaton are trying to get that ball up.
There's five personal fouls on Michigan State, one on Indiana State.
Well, Indiana State's playing the man-to-man pressure. Larry Bird clears it out. Next. Oh, what a play, and he is fouled by Vincent of Michigan State. And the foul total continues to climb for Michigan State. That's their sixth of this half.
You're really getting penetration now by the Indiana State guards. One time Nix, the next time Reed, the next time Heaton. There's his balance. Great athletic move on the inside. There's the foul.
That's what they weren't doing in the first half.
Okay. Miss again. 7 for 16 from the line, and a lot of those, the front end of 1 and 1.
I'm going to give you a question here, fellas, that Judd Heathcote's got to be thinking about. Greg Kelser, he can't let it get down too much more without bringing him back in.
Two more critical misses on the free throw line by Indiana State.
At the 11.5 minute mark, Indiana State is in the 1 and 1.
Foul on Bird. No, Nix gets the foul as they double team.
They're really trapping, but what you don't have in the front line is anybody that really likes to go one-on-one with the ball. So if they get it in there, it's just coming right back out. They really do miss Kelser at this stage.
He can play one-on-one with anyone. Johnson maneuvering. Hits the little easy five-footer.
Big basket. Super play.
He isn't going to be able to play both the guard and the forward spot.
Both Johnson and Bird, each with 14, to lead their respective teams. 11 minutes, 15 seconds left. Michigan State with an 11-point lead. Heaton and a foul on Vincent as he rammed into Bird.
What a great move without the ball by Larry Bird going for the offensive rebound. We've seen him game after game now. We're going to see him. Watch him roll right now on Jay Vincent. As soon as he feels it going, there goes the roll. He gets fouled across the head, but it gets him his position. Now he's going up for it, and there's the foul.
And Vincent now has 4 fouls. That forces Judd Heathcote to go to the bench. And number 35, Robert Gonzalez, a freshman, will come in for Vincent.
All right, there's 11-point spread. There's over 11 minutes left. There's a lifetime. We got ourselves a good game here.
Look at those shooting percentages. 37% from the foul line. Now they're into 1 and 1. It's really going to be important.
Bird makes it a 10-point ball game. Bird shoots 84% from the line on the year.
It looks like Larry's satisfied to stay in the low post now, too, and start to go for offensive rebounds.
Bird makes 1 out of 2. Nix, what an interception by Nix.
Super play. Nix.
10-point lead for Michigan State.
Larry Bird just staying down low, looking for offensive rebounds.
Nix, he made the play here in the bucket.
Last year, Indiana State lost 9 games. This year, they got Carl Nix and haven't lost any.
What I'm impressed with that the Sycamores are not afraid to challenge Urban Johnson. And there's a turnover by Magic Johnson.
I don't think it was a walk. It was an unusual looking play, but I don't believe it was a walk.
Here's that defensive play by Nix. Look at that steal.
He's just a top-notch athlete.
Looked like a shortstop.
A basket here would pull Indiana State to within 6.
And here comes Kelser off the bench. It's something Judd Heathcote just has to do.
Bird. 52-46, and Indiana State has cut 10 points off that 16-point Spartan advantage.
Judd Heathcote may have to call another timeout to get Kelser in the game. If there's no stopping the action here, he just has to have another offensive threat.
Miley's doing a good job on Magic. Magic's trying to post him up.
Markovich.
Well, Magic's trying to do it all, Al. He can't be the man to make the play and also be the scorer.
I think he can do it all.
There he goes. He misses. Look at Bird. He wanted that rebound. And Indiana State fans come to their feet.
As Indiana State lost their composure in the first half, Michigan State has now lost their composure. They need the senior. They need Kelser in there.
9.5 minutes left.
Reed's got it.
Not there. Keaton can't save it, and Donnelly comes up with a rebound. Motioning to Johnson what he wants him to do offensively.
He wants a clear out for him down in low.
They're floating off the weak side, blocking up the red mark on the court there.
Well, you notice they got three men on one side to try to get Magic three for a one-on-one move.
I feel they want to get the ball right where it is now to Charles.
Michigan State leading by six, 8:45 left.
Offense.
Nope, it's on Miley, 40 of Indiana State. You thought it should have gone the other way?
He banged in there pretty good with his shoulder. Now is going to be an important time in the game. Kelser's back in the game. If he can stay in it, we're going to see the play here. Watch him put his shoulder down when he turns the corner. Miley concentrating, looking for the pass. Here he comes. There's the shoulder pumped right in right there.
Miley's good on defense. He has quick feet. He reacts quickly, and he anticipates.
In contrast to Indiana State, Michigan State taking advantage of its charity opportunities. Oh, missed by Johnson. North 53-46 with 8:40 left.
Championship of the NCAA, best college team in the country.
Bob Heaton, not there, and Donnelly in the right spot again for Michigan State. He's played a solid game, 10 points. That's about five rebounds.
Now we're going to see a little different situation on offense with Kelser in the game. Bird is going to be guarding him.
They're spreading out. They want to catch Greg Kelser with the ball, try to get a foul on Bird.
Urban Johnson scores, and it's now 55-46 Michigan State.
That was the same move that was called a walk before. Johnson's got that long stride, pulls up, and takes it off the wrong foot.
All right, let me see the long stride he has right here, Billy.
All right, watch it. Boom.
Boom, boom.
No. Never used his bullet.
He took a walk on the boardwalk.
Larry Bird, not there. Oh, what a tip by Leroy Staley, his first basket of the game.
Preston's really doing the job, too. Michigan State goes primarily with five, six guys.
There's Kelser. He can't hit it. Knicks rebounding for the Sycamores, who trail by seven with 7.5 minutes left.
Indiana State is still sitting back in a 2-3 zone, doing a good job.
Oh, good fake.
Knicks inside, can't hit. Bird rebounds and can't score. Oh, there's a big play.
He's a little bit off balance.
And a foul on Knicks. So Indiana State had two golden opportunities, Knicks and Bird, but they could not connect.
You think he's not tired? Boy, they're grasping for everything they have right now. Here's Larry Bird. He got off balance a little bit. Great rebound, though. Just keeping the ball active. He was falling backwards. Had a hard time putting that up. There's Magic with a rebound. Here comes the foul. Putting his shoulder block.
Magic is playing his heart out. When you see a ball player put his hands on his hips, that means he's tired. When he doesn't have the ball, he can rest them on his hips.
Bird intercepts.
Oh, good idea.
Nope, he was on the sideline. And he would have made a great blind pass to a teammate. I think he has an extra eye someplace.
Bill Hodges going to the press is what brought him back. Changed the momentum of the game. Of course, Kelser was out of there for a long period of time.
Magic Johnson, he has 17 points. Larry Bird has 17. Oh, Charles with a good save.
Well, that was good. Good save is right, Dick. Real tough cat.
Bird.
He has to be careful about driving, too, because of the four fouls, he picks up the offensive guard.
They're going to isolate Kelser. He'll take Bird. There he goes.
And he hits it. He yelled short. Kelser didn't think that was going in, but he got a kind bounce.
He lost his shoe. Now we got another shoe coming from Michigan State. Trying to get it back on, but it's not on yet.
Timeout.
Bill Hodges called the timeout. Allows Kelser to get his shoe back on, but I know it wasn't for that reason.
The score, Michigan State. 68, 57, Indiana State, 48. We return to our studios for this message. The 1979 NCAA Basketball Championship Program, a memento you'll treasure. Exclusive information on the Final Four, tournament records, plus plenty of photos, features, much more contained in this collector's issue. Send a check or money order, $4 to NCAA Program, Box 1979, Lexington, Kentucky, 40594. Preceding message furnished by the NCAA. Our statistician, Craig Hislop, has Indiana State 8 for 19. From the free throw line, Michigan State 10 of 16, and that could well be the difference between a Michigan State 9-point lead and a very close game.
And Dick, I don't know how many of those would be front ends of 1-1, so that really hurt them. Must have a couple anyway.
If Indiana State doesn't score this time, the next time down, I believe that Michigan State will spread it out a little bit, try to isolate Kelcher on the side with Larry Bird.
That'd be a good move in a couple of ways, Al, because Kelcher with those foul situations would help move that clock down a little for him.
Ron Charles is the man hawking Bird most of the time in that zone. Now Irvin Johnson has him.
Good pass.
Carl Nix, son of a Baptist minister from Chicago, rattles in another bucket. He has 15. Less than 6 minutes left.
They're running their offense. Indiana State having a hard time keeping that ball away from Magic. He comes out and beats it so well.
He easily evades the steal try by Staley.
Kyle Nix will double team the first chance he gets.
Berkovich, a good reverse on the dribble into Kelcher, knocked away by Bird and saved by Ron Charles.
Second great pair of hands on Charles in the last 30 seconds. Saved two balls from going out of bounds.
7 point Spartan lead, trying to run out that clock now. And here goes Johnson. And the foul is on number 30 of Indiana State, Bob Heaton. He can't believe it.
Good backdoor move. Had it spread out fairly well. And everybody expected Johnson to come to the ball. Goes back door. Here he is. Heaton waiting on him. When we get back to that call, a man up in the air has to have room to come down.
Irvin Johnson looking for the three-point play. And the bench for the Indiana State Sycamores showing more emotion now than we've seen any time in the tournament.
The reason for it, Dick, they called it another two-shot foul, saying the man was cut. Now, that's a referee's interpretation. I don't think that he maliciously cut him out from underneath, but the rule states that an airborne man, you cannot step in underneath him.
That's the second time they call it today, Bill. They called it at the top of the program, they call it now. It's a very difficult call, unless you've been calling it all year. To start calling this a championship game, I don't think it's right.
I got to buy that.
We've seen it all year, isn't it? We've seen it twice tonight.
Well, we had one in the game in the semifinals, a definite cut, and that was not called.
21 points from Magic Johnson, a four-point play. Michigan State has an 11-point lead. Bird hits a short lead.
Boy, a lot of heart out here on the part of both of these ball clubs right now. Clock becomes a factor.
19 points for Bird, and a foul on Nix of Indiana State. And again, Bill Hodges off the bench.
I hope we can catch this one on the replay.
Here we go, Berkovich coming down. Nix, great athletic ability. I don't know why, Al. Why is that a foul on Nix?
I'm going to let that one go by.
It's not been a well-officiated game. I think we can make that comment. They've had some problems, and it's the pressure. They're doing the best they can, but we've seen some unusual calls both sides.
Looked like the man fell down that time, and the ref might have been at the wrong angle. But they've been going both ways with the calls. When they're incompetent, they'd be consistently incompetent, which isn't too bad.
That's a little strong. Now.
Here's the spread out a little bit in the Catbird seat. 4.5 minutes to go, and the Spartans have a big 11-point lead. They get 9-point lead.
And they got a spread offense going right now. This is not their normal offense.
Timeout, Michigan State. Plenty of time, 4 minutes and 25 seconds left with Michigan State leading Indiana State 61-52. We would be remiss if we didn't take time to salute the men who really make these telecasts work, and we're blessed at NBC in this tournament. I think fans should understand we've had over 400 engineers and production people to give you the pictures, the sound, the special features. We have 85 technicians working this championship series from Salt Lake City. We're happy, as they are, that NBC will be bringing you the championship games with a new contract with the NCAA. Two more years. We'll be in Indianapolis, Market Square Arena again next year. Our thanks to Walter Byers, Tom Gerstedt, Wayne Duke of the NCAA, Dave Kaywood. And while we're passing out our bouquets, our thanks to our hosts from the University of Utah, Athletic Director Arnie Farron, Tournament Manager Ned Olger, and the two Sports Information Directors, Ed McKee of Indiana State, Fred Stabley of Michigan State. Thank you, everyone, for a tremendous tournament and all your support.
Did you miss anybody, Dick?
I want to thank you guys. You made it fun. You're our leader. I'm going to miss, for everyone. You know, the college basketball season is winding down, and I'm going to miss our weekly gatherings. It's been a marvelous year. College basketball, never been better, right?
It's at the top of its game. It's top shelf, Park Avenue, all the way.
And I can't wait to see some of the great high school talent we've got in the country now coming into the ranks next year.
Now down to the final 4.5 minutes.
Definitely a spread offense now. Magic tough to handle in this. He meets the ball so well.
They keep Kelser and Charles Lowe and let Berkovich and Johnson work outside. Donnelly just kind of stays out of the way. 5 seconds, jump ball, Miley and Johnson.
That's what he goes to saying. He crossed the midcourt line on his dribble, therefore he'd get another 5 seconds to go.
Be careful of a tee, Judd.
Talking to the expert there.
Yep.
Johnson has the height advantage, but the tip, it'll be another jump ball this time. Charles and Gilbert. Now Gilbert has the leaping advantage.
Well, these are two skyhooks going up here this time. If the fans would just watch how high they get off the court on this jump ball.
That's a smart play by Charles. He knew he couldn't make a play, so he just went down and smothered the ball. That's three smart plays last minute.
Watch their feet, how high up they get.
Alex Stoller on it.
Knicks with the ball. Indiana State trails by nine.
They've got to put it up.
Oh, they got plenty of time, buddy.
Good defense by Charles.
Foul is on home. Charles of Michigan State. Four on Charles. Vincent, Charles, Kelser, all with four for Michigan State. Johnson picked up three in the first half, is clean the second half.
Larry Bird really hasn't had a shot blocked tonight, but he's had a lot of shots altered by real good defense inside. Charles doing a good job, Kelser, and when Jay Vincent was in there, he was doing a good job.
Here comes the left-hander up there. He must concentrate. These are big foul shots. You got to put him over the front rim.
It drops home. He is 2-for-5 tonight, 16 points for Knicks.
That one was a crier. It bounced all around the rim.
Michigan State.
It's amazing how Johnson comes back to the ball and meets it so well.
Oh, Larry Bird! He just reached out a knee hook and grabbed that one.
Good head fake on Bird. Berkovich thought he was going to stay inside. He went outside.
Steve Reed from 20 is short. Bird keeps it alive. Gilbert, foul, Charles. Ron Charles, fifth. Personal foul. He is disqualified.
Boy, did Gilbert get up in the air that time. The odds are he will not make this first foul shot, but let's see.
Larry Bird really upset with himself. The ball slipped right out of his hand. Here we're going to go see him battling for the rebound. I said his shots have been altered tonight. He recognizes. Look at how high up he put that ball. Here comes Gilbert. Head almost equal to the rim. Takes it up. Gets fouled on the way up.
Charles leads with 7 points. He contributed with some key baskets and key saves. And Jay Vincent, limping, number 31, returns for the Spartans. He has four fouls.
Here's that head fake by Bird. They thought he was going to stay inside, faked a little bit, good hands on the outside.
He looked like a professional ping pong player there when he got that ball.
Hey, Dick, you really hit it on the head when you said Jay Vincent limped in. I think that leg probably wearing down a little bit on him, and he can hardly run down the floor. Look at him.
You still have to shoot free throws. It's still 15 feet away and all legs, and Indiana State has not been able to hit their charities, and that's the difference in this game.
Again, that was a one-on-one.
Spartans running down the clock, 305, 304, 303. They lead by seven.
Good pass. Forced the defense to run all the way across the court.
Now, earlier, Kelzer would have driven for that ball. That's not the intent. Here comes Magic.
It looks like they're going into a complete freeze.
Nex got a piece of the wrist of Berkovic. And for Carl Nex, he leaves the game with five. And that is a critical loss to Indiana State. Following our basketball telecast tonight, it's been a very big day for all of us around the world. The signing of the Mideast Treaty celebration. Yet caution, David Brinkley reports for NBC News immediately following the final buzzer. Nex leaves with 17 points. He'll be back next year. Little consolation at this moment.
Been a great run for this ball team. Still some time left, 2:43. But the fouls have really been critical.
Number 20, Rich Nemchik from Hammond, Indiana, Jr. It'll be local news following our telecast, and that will be followed by the NBC News special on the Mideast Peace Treaty. Oh, a rare miss by Berkovic.
A big break for Indiana State.
Well, that ball went up there awful hard.
Larry Bird way outside. Can't hit. Great rebound by Kelsey. What a rebound.
And you can hear Magic hollering in the back. Greg, Greg, and he spotted him just with a sound as opposed to visual.
Turnover, Donnelly.
Oh, Judd's going crazy.
Well, what happened that time, Berkovic changed direction, and Donnelly got caught high with the ball.
We pause briefly for station identification. This is the NBC Television Network. Bob Heaton with an air ball. So Indiana State, everyone trying so hard, but the pressure all on the shoulders of the Sycamores. 2 minutes left. Michigan State took the lead at 9-8 early in the game, have not relinquished it, built up a 16-point lead. Indiana State carved it away and pulled within five, but Michigan State leads by seven and only 2 minutes left. Indiana State has had its opportunities.
Well, you'll never know when you miss those front ends of one and ones how many points that can mean for you. They've had to miss at least three or four.
Berkovic gives the Spartans an 8-point lead. They're only 1 minute 59 seconds away from the first ever National Basketball Championship to a Michigan University.
The best they did was years ago when North Carolina, led by Frank McGuire, beat them in triple overtime.
That was in the semifinals.
Yep. They had jumping Johnny Green.
Heaton inside with a left-hand prayer, and he gets it back.
That was almost the kind of shot he beat Arkansas with.
Gilbert inside. Great play by Johnson. He stole the ball. The Magic Man pulled out the rabbit.
He has not thrown the ball away at all tonight. He hadn't had a chance to make spectacular passes.
Foul out of desperation by Reed of Indiana State, his second.
They've got to foul somebody, but all the guys out there handling the ball can shoot these fouls. Now, here we see the play. Inside, Alex Gilbert has it right where he'd love to have it. Magic comes down over the top, just strips him of the ball.
Sleight of hand by the Magic Man.
Yep, he has Houdini hands.
Real good free throw shooters in the game right now, handling that ball for Michigan State.
The Spartans now lead by nine. Terry Donnelly looking for his 12th point.
And Dick, we talked about unsung heroes when this game started. Terry Donnelly's been a man that's a big clutch shot.
Yeah, those four shots from the outside were just at the right time.
1:26 left. Sycamores have to score and score in a hurry. Nemchek banks it in. His first basket. Timeout. Indiana State with a score 63-56 and 1:17 left. That's how much time left. Desperation for the Sycamores. Take us into the huddle with Judd Heaptuck. What's he telling his Spartans?
He's saying spread it out. Let's try to get on the foul line. Don't give them any three-point play. Stay in a tight 2-3 zone. Circle around Larry Bird. Let them try to beat us from 20 feet out if they get the ball.
And I'm sure he's telling no silly fouls. They want that clock to keep moving. Jay Vincent can hardly walk out here. That leg is really bothering him.
To get the ball to the man, they want to be in control. Irvin Johnson.
No one should feel sad for Indiana State if they don't win. They've done a magnificent job. They're a great ball club.
Foul is on Reed. That stops the clock with 1:06 left and sends Donnelly to the line. Reed's third foul.
It's not a bad move. Try to steal the ball but get the foul. They can't afford to let the clock keep moving.
Joel Hodges, Judd Heathcote. One of the sad aspects of this tournament. 40 start and 39 leave losers. Only one can smile for the months ahead.
I think we'll get a good smile from Judd. The whole tournament, he's been very intense. He doesn't fool around with the ball game. He makes sure he hasn't won before he makes any substitutions.
Donnelly now has 13 points. And Michigan State leads by 9. Reed hits a long 25-footer. Timeout of Indiana State.
Time is called. What happened there, Dick? Larry Bird grabbed the ball right out of the basket and called time. Donnelly said, hey, you can't get away with that one.
Larry Bird, and I know a lot of fans who have watched him all season long are saying, oh, if he had just had an average shooting game, we'd be national champions. But again, he has played under such tremendous defensive pressure.
Michigan State, Magic Johnson, Greg Kelso, they were the world's fair tonight.
Now, they're the best team we saw the last month of this year. There's no question about it.
They were on an uptick. They hit a little drought in the middle of the season. And then they were off to the races.
Now, let's give some credit to their league, too. I think that's what made them such a competitive team. The Big Ten this year had some incredible competition. Maybe the greatest year a conference has ever had in the country.
Bill Hodges, he graduated from Marion College in Indiana in 1970 after 4 years in the Air Force. An assistant coach, and let's pay tribute to those men too. The assistants often overlooked. They struggle. They work for years and years behind the head man before they get their chance. Under adversity, Hodges replacing the physically ill King, and he's had a great year. And Judd Heathcote, his counterpart, several years at the University of Montana. A surprise pick by Michigan State. The coup de grace. Michigan State now starts to celebrate. Offensive foul, I believe, against Larry Bird. And now the Spartans starting to show the victory smiles. Bill Hodges knows it's all but over. He trails by 9, 49 seconds left. Oh, a tremendous collision at midcourt.
Wow.
And what's the call? The call is against Nemchek of Indiana State.
He's the one that had the offensive foul, too, but they're battling out there, and Indiana State had to take the gamble out with that steal to allow the long pass.
Wow. They're going to call two fouls on that again, but double. He stepped in, and they really hit each other. I'm pleased no one's hurt. There's 48 seconds left, and there comes the cry out for Michigan State Spartans. They're number one, and they are number one.
And
they
their number one player, Irvin Magic Johnson, wins for his university $5,000. $1,000 during the regular year, $5,000 in this championship game. Very few can argue that that sophomore, I said today, someone asked me, if I could put a name on the back of his uniform, I would write joy. The joy for this game, the joy that he has brought his fans and anyone who loves basketball.
As Judge said, he's the best ball player in the country, pro, college, or high school.
Reed comes back to hit two from
that's going to be a technical foul. Going to be a technical foul. What happened? Larry Bird
slapped the ball away from Magic Johnson while he was out of bounds. It's automatic technical foul. Hey, you have to pull all the stops when you get here. What a great ball player Larry Bird is, but this was accurately called right here. Now watch it. The ball is, isn't that Magic's out of bounds.
Isn't that normally a warning first on that when you break the plane, Billy?
Nope. That's Wells' ball.
That's a good call by the official because Bird was very quick in his move. Little frosting for Magic Johnson. Michigan State 69, Indiana State 60. Johnson leads all scorers with 22. Bird 19 for Indiana State.
Well, got the national champs, Michigan State.
Look at Irvin Johnson. He turned to the official, two fingers out, saying, Doug, he wants two. That's Magic says, I'm no one, just one. That was intentional.
Larry Bird telling his teammates, hey, we got nothing to be sad about, but let's keep playing solid ball here. You don't want to turn the game into a farce.
Can we say, Al McGuire, two stars were just a bit too much for one?
Well, as I said earlier in the show, the third man in the ring was the deciding factor, Greg Kelsey.
Yeah, Johnson against Bird, both legitimate All-Americans, both big men, a new evolution of the game, the big man with the great passes, but Michigan State also had Greg Kelsey.
And you know, thinking back to last year when Kentucky went all the way through, this Michigan State team was a year younger, but they almost knocked off the Kentucky Wildcats last year in that regional.
Kentucky beat them by only 3, 52-49.
I also want to thank Larry Bird for giving us so many thrills this year and being a perfect gentleman.
Gilbert has just scored 18 seconds. Johnson fouled by Bird as those two great stars collide.
Well, before this game started, Matt, oh, what a sight right there.
Yeah, what they're saying, play to our potential. Play to our potential.
That was said. I think they said with their eyes, we did it.
We did it.
Yep. They're going to get their rings and their wristwatch and be prouder for the rest of their life.
Those memories will be a lot bigger than any kind of memento they'll ever give them.
There's Judd breaking out the smile.
Not yet.
There he is.
There's 15 seconds.
No,
he's not.
They're getting him.
No, he's got 15 seconds. Let's see if we can catch a smile. All right.
Irvin Johnson tacks on two more. He has 24.
A reminder of our award ceremony.
There's the pass. Look at Johnson.
Oh,
there
we go.
It's all over. Michigan State University, national champions, 1979. They chant that cry on every campus in every sport. Everyone wants to be number one. But only one can make it. And Larry Bird, a great star, congratulates the victors.
Dick, I enjoyed working with you and Billy.
Same here again.
Irvin Johnson leads his Michigan State team to the final score, 75-64. The first ever national basketball championship for the Spartans of Michigan State. And Brian Gumbel has the game star and his head coach, Judd Heathcote.
Thank you, Dick. I am with two very, very happy people here, Magic and Judd. Magic, not only were you a leader on offense, I thought you did a great job on Larry Bird in the zone, denying him the ball.
Yes, Coach gave us a good game plan to go against Larry Bird, and all we had to do was go out and do it. And if we did it, he said we would win. That's what we done.
Judd, I know you didn't count on Larry Bird hitting as poorly from the field as he did. Were you surprised they didn't try to force the ball into him more?
Well, I think that we had a man and a half on him, Brian, and it was tough to get it in. I thought maybe they could have gone to him a little more, but I think they worked the ball. Hey, this was a tough, tough game for us. They gave us all we wanted, and we're just very, very happy to win.
Were either of you surprised at how close the officials were calling the ball game early on?
No. Well, I sure was, but maybe he wasn't.
I wasn't, because they wanted to set the tempo for the game, and they didn't want it to get out of hand. So
you seem to lose the rhythm a little bit at the 15-minute mark in the second half when Kelsey left the ball game. He sat on the bench for 7 minutes, and then you got outscored 14-4. What happened?
Well, we might have become a little too conservative. And yet, without Gregory in there, we have a tough time running our offense. So we're just glad we could hang in there, and the magic man was super as usual and kept us in there.
Let me ask two final questions. The rumors say that you've played your last college game and that you're heading away from Michigan State. You first.
I can't really say. I haven't said that at all. Everybody's just saying that. As far as I know right now, I'll be back. But, you know, everybody got the rumor I'm leaving, but I haven't said that.
John, how about you?
Those are just rumors, Brian, just rumors.
Right. Gentlemen, congratulations. Super Bowl game.
Thank you. That picture.
Let's go back to Dick.
Okay, Brian, tells it all. You feel it. You feel it with him.
He's a great competitor. You know, in Terre Haute, when I first met him, I said, Larry, wouldn't you rather lose a ball game before you can win to the NCAA? He says, Coach, I don't want to lose any ball game. He's such a fierce competitor. He's a winner.
Okay, let's recap it. Billy Packer, your impressions. I think it was an excellent basketball game. The zone by Michigan State was the key. You never could get an easy shot. Right now, let's go back to Brian Gumbel.
Okay, Dick, thank you very much. I'm standing with a very disappointed Bill Hodges, who concluded a super season in the worst way for him. You had trouble penetrating the Michigan State zone, didn't you?
Well, first of all, Brian, you're wrong. I'm not disappointed. The Lord blessed us with a great year, and I'm extremely happy with that. I think it's not a matter of how much trouble we had with our zone. It's just, you know, if we'd hit our free throws, it would have been a heck of a basketball game. We hit a much better free throw percentage than that, and if it had been tight, you know, and we'd had a chance to win, I think maybe we would have. But we can't be disappointed. Our guys played great all year. They never gave up, and I don't think they ever will.
Bill, congratulations to you. We'll look for you back here again next year.
Thank you very much.
I appreciate you coming on. Let's go back to Dick.
So ends this classic in Salt Lake City, 15,410, the Michigan State University Spartans. Rally from a 5-4 season start, win 21 of their last 23, and take home the championship gauntlet. For Brian Gumbel, Billy Packer, Al McGuire, Dick Enberg, good night from Salt Lake.
Promotional fee has been paid to NBC by United Airlines. United is building the largest airline in the world around you. Fly the friendly skies.
The executive producer of NBC's National Collegiate Basketball Championship, Don Olmeyer. Congratulations, gentlemen. Tonight's telecast, finally produced by George Finkel and astutely directed by Harry Coyle. Technical director, Bill Tobey. Associate Director of Producer, Kenneth Edmondson, and the Associate Director, Randy Wands. Feature Producer, Don McGuire. Remember, Saturday, April 7th, 2 o'clock Eastern Time, Major League Baseball returns. Milwaukee at New York Yankees or Philadelphia visit St. Louis. Next Saturday at 3:30 and Sunday at 2, it's LPGA action with the top women golfers at the Kemper Open. And Sports World Sunday at 4 Eastern Time features the Golden Gloves Association of America Tournament of Champions. Now following local news, stay tuned for NBC News Special on the Egyptian-Israeli Peace Treaty, then the Johnny Carson Show. Follows on NBC.